Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I'm Father Steve Sellers, and thank you so much for tuning in today for this brief daily message of hope. You know, there's a passage in our gospel lesson this morning from John chapter 12, which has been on my mind today, where Jesus says, whoever serves me must follow me. And we know that is his summons to those who want to be part of his fellowship. He said, if you really want to be my disciple, you do three things. You deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. What does it mean to follow Jesus? And where is he leading you? Where is he leading me? That's always on my mind because, you know, in order to understand the nature of the call to be part of the fellowship of his communion, his faith, his people, it's to know what he's calling us to be. Now, the answer to where is Jesus calling you, where is he leading you, is always, first and foremost, closer to himself. Jesus, the Lord, is always calling us to be closer and closer to him. He desires a deep relationship with each one of us, not a second hand or a third hand or a hearsay relationship. He doesn't want us to know all about him. He wants us to know him. And to do that, he calls us closer and closer to himself. That's the first answer. Where is Jesus calling me? He's calling me to himself, closer. But then as part of that call, he wants us to go where he's going. He said, if you really want to be part of his fellowship, then follow me. So where is he leading us? Well, I believe he's calling us to the same places he visited in the Gospels. Jesus was always going to those who were sick, those who were in distress, those who were confused, those who were lost, those who were lonely, those who were suffering from grief or trouble. The troubled, the sorrowful, the sick, the needy, the friendless, the strangers. Jesus is always leading us to help those who are the least of his children. We read about them in Matthew 25 in the parable of the Last Judgment. Those who are hungry, those who are thirsty, those who are strangers, naked, those who are sick and in prison. Jesus calls us to them because he's leading us to them as he calls us closer and closer to himself. And I was thinking today about this wonderful old hymn, and Dot has been very quiet this morning. And I think what that is that little toy called the Kong. Bring it up here, Dot. Here's your toy. This is one of the greatest inventions ever made for dogs. It's a very hard, let me see that. She keeps dropping it out my feet. This is one of the greatest inventions ever made. A very hard piece of rubber that you can fill with treats, with peanut butter. Come here, Doc. Come here. And she's like, come on, come on. You want this? Get on up here. Get on up here. You want this? Of course she does. It's got a little bit of peanut butter in it, and that's wonderful. But I was praying a hymn from the middle of the 19th century called Glad Tidings, published Glad Tidings. Marianne Thompson wrote the words to that and the hymn Tidings by James Walsh. And the first verse has always haunted me, where it says, O Zion, haste, thy mission high fulfilling, to tell to all the world that God is light. Listen to this. That he who made all nations is not willing one soul should fail to know his love and might. The Lord is not willing that even one soul should fail to know him. And that's where he calls us, to those who don't know him. And remember, he first of all calls you closer to himself. And remember, he loves you. He's there. He's done everything necessary for us to be part of his fellowship. Come here. Come on, Doc. Come on. Now we're going to play now. I hope you have a blessed day today. And remember that the Lord is with you. He loves you and he cares deeply for you. And listen to the call because you're being called closer to the Lord. God bless you.